We're actually now in the premises of Metropolia University of Applied Sciences. The city is Espoo and we're in Finland. And this is our workshop for the Sohio project, which is now ending. And we have been implementing autonomous or automatic robot buses in Finland in open streets, in mixed traffic. The hardware we were using are two EZ10 robot buses. They are set up on a fixed route somewhere in the city. Then they go and autonomously or automatically follow that route. They have obstacle detection lasers, so they don't hit anything. What they don't do is they don't understand any traffic rules, or they can't overtake anything, or that sort of stuff. So, and also what they don't have at the moment is they don't have remote operation controls. So we have to have an operator on board. They move at 12 kilometers an hour at the moment. That's not the technical top speed, but that's the top speed that is regarded as the safe top speed. So 12 kilometers an hour is quite low, so we are disturbing the open traffic and the mixed traffic. Finding routes where the disturbance is tolerable is quite hard. So far, the pedestrian lanes and routes that use pedestrian lanes have been the most promising. Basically, we have three sites. One of them was this beachfront road in Helsinki, which proved to be quite hard to operate because of the other traffic, the mixed traffic. We didn't have any problems with the localization or that sort of stuff, but the buses need, for the localization, the buses need built-up environments. They use feature-based localization for the most part, and that means that we have to have big varying size buildings alongside the route, because the robot buses themselves, they make the localization map as they go. The infrastructure of the route has to be adapted for the buses. So that means that when we go to a site where we want the bus to run, we have to adapt the site so that the bus, for example, it does have the right of way all the time. Or we have to have traffic lights so that we can control them, so that we get the green light every time we pass it, because the bus doesn't know when to stop if it sees a red light. The Finnish traffic legislation somehow forgot to mention in the 70s that the bus has to have a driver and a steering wheel. So when it came that we had autonomous buses in the world, it was possible for us to have this open road autonomous testing. The general reaction is curiosity and like amusement and the urge to test something new. We have conducted one peer-reviewed study of the people's reactions to a traffic system that doesn't have operator, and people, they also say that they are afraid to come in. But what we have learned also is that people are very adaptive, so quite quickly they forget that they're in a automatically moving vehicle. What we have achieved is a massive amount of user data and also know-how and knowledge of the technical side and the infrastructural side of this thing. So what we can actually now do and what we are doing is we are disseminating our knowledge to other cities, other organizations, other projects. We have two big projects, one of the Sohio Baltic, which is the next project after Sohio, which will be basically Sohio project in Baltic states around the Baltic Sea. So we will be having buses in different cities, maybe open traffic, maybe closed areas. We have the weather, which is quite challenging, and we have this saying that if it works in Finland, it works everywhere. I think other countries in the European Union would be able to learn what we have been doing. I will say that within probably 5 years we will have more advancement and more like not pilot projects anymore. For the 5 years, I think we will be seeing these throughout Europe, Asia, United States.